Choose your character.
What sport do you play? I'm a speed skater. Wait, what? I'm a speed skater. Like racing? On ice? Yep. It's like you just picked the most random sport.
For me, I really like corn.
What do you like about corn?
It's corn! A good corn but not. It has the juice.
Into a long explanation defending these activities and their relevance to breed and breed purpose and breed history. But honestly, we do them because they're fun. And I do a lot of other activities because they're fun too. Having fun with your dogs is in itself worthwhile. I think that's probably why most people have dogs. And you can have fun with your dogs in many different ways. But since my dogs and I find sports fun, we're gonna keep doing them.
German and the poodle, first successfully catching the ball, returning to their handlers encouraged on. And the second set of dogs go. There are four dogs in each team. Each dog must run three times for a maximum total possible of 12 points.
That's what they say.
Hard work.
I earn my pay.
Hard work.
I get off the rock. I move on down.
Hard work.
Got to go. Make the call.
Millionaire.
I started working with a new trainer a few months ago, and she introduced us to nose work, and it's made the biggest difference for us. If you don't know, Nelly struggles with fear-based reactivity and just all-around anxiety, and this has really been a big confidence builder for her, and it's also given her a job. We've tried a good amount of different dog sports in the past, but none of them have ever stuck, and she's never really enjoyed any of them, but this one she just really seems to love, and she's really engaged in it, and it's really made a difference for us. This is only her second vehicle search ever, so that's why we're using paired hides, but she did so good and she had such a good time. I really can't recommend nose work enough.
About corn.
It's cold! A big lump of knobs, it has the juice. I can run a more beautiful thing. It's cold! I can tell you all about it. I mean, look at this thing.
Don't answer fun and hide. It's a wonderful, wonderful life. Don't answer fun.
My favorite thing about terrier trials is for once I can appreciate how much Lottie barks. She loves it, she's a great barker, and it really shows the power of purposeful breeding. So, warning, terrier sounds.
Bring that ass back like a boom, 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 boom.
Run so fast, why do I see you in a race car sometimes? 'Cause it's cool.
I love myself.
The world is a ghetto because it makes you sad.
I love myself.
But they can do what they want with everyone, I don't mind.
I love myself.
You said I gotta give up, nice and warm to suicide.
I love myself.
One day at a time, drunk or shy.
They wanna say it's a war outside, and a bomb in the street, and a gun in the hood, and a mob of police, and a rock. And a line full of fiend and a bottle full of lean and a model on a scheme, yeah. These days of frustration, keep y'all on tuck and rotation. I duck these cold faces, post up, he fight for four faces. Dreams are reality's peace. Blow steam in the face of the beast. The sky can fall down, the wind can cry now. The strong in me are still.
Just like a rocket, man.
Okay.
Fly so high where I need to come down for oxygen.
Hey.
'Cause once we started, baby, ain't no stopping in.
Hey.
'Cause I just wanna live.
We were at a terrier trial this weekend, and I wanted to share some of the fun things that we do there. Most of these sports are designed to test the dog's instincts. So this is brush hunt. Brush hunt is where they take a tube with a rat inside, so the rat's safe. They hide it somewhere in kind of like a natural area, and the judge calls it when they think the dog's found it. So Lottie found it pretty quickly. She got third in this search. This is the tunnel vision. The tunnel vision is super fun for people because it's basically a more spectator-friendly version of go-to-ground, which is our main sport. So these narrow tunnels are made to replicate an animal's burrow because the breed's historic purpose was chasing animals down their burrows and then either baying so the hunter knew where they were or even driving them out. In go-to-ground, which is the big sport, these burrows are actually set into the ground, so it even resembles it more closely, but this does make it more boring for the handler because you just release your dog and then really hope you don't see them again and instead you hear barking when they find the rat.
Come on.
He spit it out. Did you see that?
Lactose and
yeah.
Tone.
I threw it right in his mouth.
He didn't even want it. Don't
step
on my back. He's gonna eat. Yeah. Let's do this.
Rising from the wreckage, count down the seconds. It's out to engines. Racing was the best part of his life, and when it ended, well, we both know he was never the same after that.
Hoping you take that jump, you don't feel the fall.
Is that what you think?
Can you watch this, folks? This is just a young man trying to fight for extra yards. Ball's a little too loose.
Racing wasn't the best part of Hud's life.
Open the crowd screams out, screaming your name.
You were.
Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay.
If you're new to dog sports and interested in agility, I highly recommend checking out kind of the Agility CGC or the ACT title. This is a pass-fail test that is set up in a way to get you familiar with agility trials. So you can see you have your course maps up on the wall. You have your table of prizes and ribbons for those who qualify. There's a run order where you sign in, and then the evaluator will call everyone into the ring for a briefing. The ACT briefings are always really welcoming because the evaluators use it as an educational opportunity for anyone new to the sport or for dog trials in general. Your dog gets practice being crated while you're off listening to the evaluator's instructions. And when the briefing is over, you're given an opportunity to walk the course. I didn't volunteer at this event, but here's one of Tilney's ACT runs that I did a year ago. While for safety, your dog should have some agility training prior to doing an ACT, the courses are going to be easier than even the agility novice ones. At the ACT 1 level, you can expect one lead change and otherwise pretty much just a circle. The ACT 1 jumpers only uses jumps and tunnels, and the ACT 2 jumpers adds a set of 6 weaves. I think it's a really attainable first goal for those who are new to agility and want to start testing if their skills are truly trial ready.
This year for Christmas, I set a coon drag for the hounds. I bought a hide and odor off of hunting website. Here you can see Dakota circling back around to the start of that track, picking up that scent. Once Clover picks that scent up, she opens up to let me know. And then for the rest of the way, they follow it pretty closely, all the way to the tree. You can see Briar's is back off in the distance. He's ahead of the game. He beats everyone to the tree. Once everyone has remained at the tree, I decided to tease them with the hide a little bit just to help build drive to stay on the tree. Briar and Clover have both done field trials where they finished a track to tree, but aren't traditionally trained for raccoon hunting. Dakota has never trialed, never finished a track to tree before. She's never been put on a track. So I'm pretty happy with how this has turned out with her today.